reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear, that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, I have not turned my back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield. Buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help. Therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame.
Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped, Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness. And found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue would confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
is my body. Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed on behalf of many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, now on I shall not drink this fruit of vine until the day when I drink it with you new in the kingdom of my Father. Then after singing the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, this night all of you will have your faith in me shaken. For it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be dispersed. But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you to Galilee. Peter said to him in reply,
though all may have their faith in you shaken, mine will never be.
Jesus said to him, amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times. Peter said to him,
even though I should have to die with you, I will not deny you.
And all the disciples spoke likewise. Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, sit here while I go over there and pray. He took along Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to feel sorrow and distress. Then he said to them, my soul is sorrowful even to death. Remain here and keep watch with me. He advanced a little and fell prostrate in prayer, saying, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will. When he returned to his disciples, he found them asleep. He said to Peter, so you could not keep watch with me for 1 hour? Watch and pray, that you may not undergo the test. For the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Withdrawing the second time, he prayed again. My Father, if it is not possible that this cup pass without my drinking it, your will be done. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open. He left them and withdrew again and prayed a third time, saying the same thing again. Then he returned to his disciples and said to them, are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Behold, the hour is at hand when the Son of Man is being handed over to sinners. Get up. Let us go. Look, my betrayer is at hand.
While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a large crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests and the elders of the people. His betrayer had arranged a sign with them, saying,
the man I shall kiss is the one. Arrest him.
Immediately he went over to Jesus and said,
hail, Rabbi.
And he kissed him. Jesus answered him,
friend, do what you have come to.
Then stepping forward, they laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. And behold, one of those who accompanied Jesus put his hand to his sword, drew it, and struck the high priest's servant, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to him,
put your sword back into its sheath. For all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I could not call upon my Father, and he would not provide me at this moment with more than 12 legions of angels? But then, how would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say that it must come to pass in this way?
At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds,
have you come out as against the robber, the swords and clubs this evening. Day after day I sat teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me. But all this has come to pass, that the writings of the prophets may be fulfilled. Then all the disciples left him and fled. Those who had arrested Jesus led him away to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the scribes and the elders were assembling. Peter was following him at a distance as far as the high priest's courtyard. And going inside, he sat down with the servants to see the outcome. The chief priest and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain false testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. Finally, two came forward who stated,
"This man said, 'I destroy the temple of God, and in 3 days rebuild it.'"
The high priest rose and addressed him.
"Have you no answer? What are these men testifying against you?"
But Jesus was silent. Then the high priest said to him,
"I order you to tell us under oath before the living God whether you are the Christ, the Son of God."
Jesus said to him in reply, "You have said so. But I tell you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his robes and said,
"He has blasphemed. What further need have we of witnesses? You have now heard the blasphemy. What is your opinion?"
They said in reply,
"He deserves to die."
They spat in his face and struck him, while some slapped him, saying,
"Crucify Christ, who is the answer to you."
Now Peter was outside, sitting in the courtyard. One of the maids came over to him and said,
"You too were with Jesus of Galilee."
But he denied it in front of everyone, saying,
"I do not know what you are talking about."
As he went out to the gate, another girl saw him and said to those who were there,
"This man was with Jesus of Nazareth."
Again, he denied it with an oath,
"I do not know the man."
A little later, the bystanders came over and said to Peter,
"Surely you too are one of them, even your speech gives you away."
At that, he began to curse and to swear,
"I do not know the man."
And immediately, a cock crowed. Then Peter remembered the word that Jesus had spoken, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. He went out began to weep bitterly. When it was morning, all the chief priests and the elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. They bound him, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate, the governor. Then Judas, his betrayer, seeing that Jesus had been condemned, deeply regretted what he had done. He returned the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, saying,
"I have sinned in betraying innocent blood."
They said,
"What is that to us? Look to it yourself."
Flinging the money into the temple, he departed. He went off and hanged himself. The chief priests gathered up the money, but said,
"It is not lawful to profit this in temple treasury, for it is the price of blood."
After consultation, they used it to buy the potter's field as a burial place for foreigners. That is why that field, even today, is called the Field of Blood. Then was fulfilled what had been said through Jeremiah the prophet, and they took 30 pieces of silver, the value of a man with a price on his head, a price set by some of the Israelites, and they paid it out for potter's field, just as the Lord had commanded him. Now Jesus stood before the governor, Pontius Pilate, and he questioned him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
Jesus said, "You He made no answer. Then Pilate said to him,
Do you not hear how many things they are testifying against you?
But he did not answer him one word. So that the governor was greatly amazed. And on the occasion of the feast, the governor was accustomed to release to the crowd one prisoner whom they wished. And at that time they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had assembled, Pilate said to them,
Which one do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus called Christ?
For he knew that it was out of envy that they had handed him over. While he was still seated on the bench, his wife sent him a message. Have nothing to do with that righteous man. I suffered much in a dream today because of him. The chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowds to ask for Barabbas, but to destroy Jesus. The governor said to them in reply,
Which of the two do you want me to release to you?
And they answered,
Barabbas.
Pilate said to them,
Then what shall I do with Jesus called Christ?
And they all said,
Let him be crucified.
But he said,
Why? What evil has he done?
They only shouted the louder,
Let him be crucified.
When Pilate saw that he was not succeeding at all, but that a riot was breaking out instead, he took water and washed his hands in the sight of the crowd, saying,
I am innocent of this man's blood. Look to it yourselves.
And the whole people said in reply,
His blood be upon us and upon our children.
Then he released Barabbas to them. But after he had Jesus scourged, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus inside the praetorium and gathered the whole cohort around him. They stripped off all his clothes, threw a scarlet military cloak about him, then weaving a crown out of thorns, they placed it on his head and a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying,
Hail, King of the Jews!
They spat upon him and took the reed and kept striking him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him off to crucify him. As they were going out, they met a Cyrenian named Simon. This man they pressed into service to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of the skull, they gave Jesus wine to drink, mixed with gall. But when he had tasted it, he refused to drink. After they had crucified him, they divided his garments by casting lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And they placed over his head the written charge against him, This is Jesus, the King of the Jews. Two revolutionaries were crucified with him, one on his right and the other on his left. Those passing by reviled, shaking their heads and saying,
You who destroyed the temple and rebuilt it in 3 days, save yourself, you are the Son of God, and come down from the cross.
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes and the elders mocked him and said,
He saved others, he cannot save himself, so he is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross now, and you will believe.
Revolutionaries who were crucified with him also kept abusing him in the same way. From noon onward, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And about 3:00, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
Li, li, lama sabachthani,
which means,
my God, why have you forsaken me?
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
This one is calling for Elijah.
and immediately one of them ran to get a sponge. He soaked it in wine, and putting it on a reed, gave it to him to drink. But the rest said,
"Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to save him."
But Jesus cried out again in a loud voice and gave up his spirit. The earth quaked, rocks were split, tombs were opened, and the bodies of many saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And coming forth from their tombs after his resurrection, they entered the holy city and appeared to many. The centurion and the men with him, who were keeping watch over Jesus, feared greatly when they saw the earthquake and all that was happening. And they said, "Now there were many women there, looking on from a distance, who had followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering to him. Among them were Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who was himself a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be handed over. Taking the body, Joseph wrapped it in clean linen and laid it in his new tomb that he had hewn in the rock. Then he rolled a huge stone over the entrance to the tomb and departed. But Mary Magdalene and the other Mary remained sitting there facing the tomb. Next day, the one following the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said,
"Sir, you remember that this impostor also lied, said, 'After 3 days I will be raised up.' He orders him and prayed to be stirred until the third day.
Secure it as best you can."
So they went and secured the tomb by fixing a seal to the stone and setting the guard.
The Gospel of the Lord.
True to Jesus for just 1 hour? You say you just followed the crowd here at Mass. You just read the part you were supposed to read. Is that all you can say for yourself? Are you telling me that it's any different outside of church? Can't you go a full hour with Jesus in prayer without distraction? I know I can. Can't you say on Sunday that you will live and maybe even die with Christ? Can't you make it through the week without breaking the promise? Did you go to reconciliation this Lent? You have 4 more days. Did you make a Lenten resolution and keep it? These may be negative Lenten thoughts, frequently bringing our guilt to mind, but we're coming toward the end of Lent. Have you progressed enough in Lent to stop fasting? Maybe you'll stop fasting when Lent is over, but will you at least continue praying more and giving alms? Will you continue to think of Jesus and try and be closer to Him? This being Sunday, let me also be a little bit more positive. You know, spring's coming, we see it out there. We see beautiful flowers, and like the flowering crab tree over there, it's beautiful. I don't think I've ever seen that group of flowering crabs look any better. And there's other beauty around the property here. The grass could use a little touch, but the flowers are blooming. The trees and shrubs are looking good. God gave us rain, He gave us trees, He gave us flowers, He gave us a lot of things. But the reason they look so good is because somebody cared for them, somebody fertilized them. And that's the way it is with us. We've got to use a little fertilizer. We've got to work at it a little bit. It doesn't just come because we say we believe on Sunday. As Lent comes to an end, continue your good habits of more prayer, more almsgiving, and even a little fasting. Continue to work to do your part to be closer to God.